this stuff is so boring. Who even cares if some ancient people couldn't drink alcohol 100 years ago?
Hey there, Timmy.
Oh my gosh, mister. You scared the jeepers out of me.
How would you like to take a break from doing all of that hard work and studying and come learn about the alcohol prohibition era?
Boy, would I. Where am I, mister?
Why, Timmy, we're in a speakeasy.
Speak what?
Shh, 1 second, I'll explain.
Who is it?
Peanut butter.
With what?
Strawberry jelly.
In what?
In a sandwich.
All right.
Who are you? You don't know me. I'm notorious bootlegger George Remus.
Bootlegger?
A bootlegger is someone who transported alcohol illegally during the Prohibition era. Do you know what the Prohibition era was?
No, not a clue.
Narrator, explain to Timmy, please.
The Prohibition era began with the enactment of the 18th Amendment. It stated that the manufacture, sale, and transportation of alcohol were illegal. President Woodrow Wilson vetoed the bill on October 28, 1919, but Congress overrode the veto on the same day. The amendment was fully ratified on January 16, 1919, and a year grace period was allowed before the amendment went into full effect, which would be on January 16, 1920. Advocates for passing the 18th Amendment believe that alcohol was responsible for all the acts of violence and crimes that were committed in our country, and that it was hurtful towards the social, civil, and religious interests of men. The Prohibition era was also during the time of World War I. Those in favor of banning alcohol believed that if people would spend less money on alcohol, then more money would go towards the war movement, and keeping soldiers away from alcohol would improve their combat skills and make for a better army. Women in the church also played a big role in this movement. Women were sick of dealing with their drunk husbands, and women were also sick of their husbands going out to saloons and wasting all their family money, making it so that they were unable to support their family. Following the enactment of the 18th Amendment came the enactment of the Volstead Act. It specified that the production and sale of alcoholic beverages were illegal except for medical and religious purposes. Corrupt doctors would prescribe medicine that contained whiskey in return for bribes. During the Prohibition era, many people would drink something called near beer. Near beer was a grain-based beverage with an alcoholic content of 0.5%. The public wasn't satisfied with drinking near beer, but brewers quickly found a way to satisfy their customers' thirst for drinking alcohol. In the process of creating near beer, they would create full-strength alcohol but skip the step where you would draw off all the liquor, a step that their law required. Understaffed and overworked government inspectors were rarely able to detect what was really in those millions of bottles of beer. Many men also converted their garages into workshops, from workshops to breweries. Amateur brewers produced an estimated value of 700 million gallons of beer annually. Why are we in the bathroom? Wait, you don't... Oh, that's disgusting.
That's right, we made alcohol in the bathtubs. Well, not me specifically, I was a professional. But amateurs used to mix glycerin, water, and juniper oil to make bathroom gin, which is a very popular drink.
Well, let me show you more about how we ruled the Prohibition era.
Oh boy!
We made the illegal whiskey at night, so people referred to us as moonshiners. We gangsters earned so much money from selling alcohol. Those who sold the alcohol were called bootleggers. Me, I wasn't one of them. I was in control of an entire business. I remember threatening, beating, and killing anyone who got in my way, just like it was yesterday. Some of those people included prohibition agents and elected officials.
Organized crime increased as bootleggers supplied alcohol to the masses in a large-scale black market network. Did you know that the term bootlegging derived from when people would hide flasks of whiskey inside their sleeves or their boots, hence the name bootlegging? Many big American gangsters such as Al Capone and Charles Lucky Luciano created bootlegging empires in Chicago and New York. Although the Volstead Act stated that it was illegal to buy, sell, or distribute liquor, one could still drink liquor in their own home, legally. As the Prohibition era dragged on, people grew more and more tired of obeying the laws pertaining to banning alcohol, and arrests involving the Volstead Act and the 18th Amendment skyrocketed. On October 27th, the Boston Globe admitted that the Prohibition era and the laws involving Prohibition were an illegal violation of personal liberty. Even Joseph Walker, a politician who fought strongly for the banning of alcohol, changed his mind when he realized that the Prohibition movement was not working. Similar changes in attitude occurred all across the country, leading to the 21st Amendment, which was passed on February 5, 1933, which marked the end of the Prohibition era, since it said that it was legal to buy, sell, and transport liquor.
Well, from early on, alcohol was accepted as a divine blessing in America. People believed that alcohol brought pleasure, cured disease, and gave courage to fighting men. In 1910, an average American drank 7 gallons in a year. And a decade later, the number rose up to 10 gallons per person. After the prohibition really started to take effect, people were either relieved to have a nation sober, or they were angry. Millions of Americans were against this new law. It was very hard to enforce the prohibition. The federal government approved $6.5 million to start the enforcement, which was far too little.